And like that, we are back in Washington, D.C. Good morning, guys. Welcome to a new semester. You can hear the hustle and bustle of the city of Washington this morning, this beautiful Monday morning. This is my little fit. I'm going to show y'all in a little bit, but good morning. I just wanted to come in and say hi to y'all, give y'all a different view. The city just looks so beautiful this morning. The weather is a little chilly, but like, I'm about to go put on some boots. My first class is at 1:40. It's super noisy right now, but honestly, like, I just wanted to give y'all a different view. I'm always in my fucking bathroom. But it's my first class is at 1:40. It's about 11:30 right now. I'm already done dressing up and all that. I'm about to go eat breakfast and just get my day started. It's a bit of a fast morning, so I'm just gonna get my day started. But good morning, y'all. So yes, it is a new semester. Can y'all see the little background? I'm giving you a little spice right now. I'm trying to decorate. I'm like mid-decoration right now. I just came in from Texas on Friday. Today's Monday. School just started. My first class is criminal law. Y'all, the grades for last semester hasn't dropped yet, and it's like we're about to start a new semester. What's going on? But actually, one torts dropped this morning, and I looked at it, and that's what I'm gonna say. But yes, my first class this morning is criminal law. That's my only class today. It's from 1:40 to 2:55. Right now, I low-key just want to get on campus by like 12:30 ish, so I can just have some time to, like, you know, be my little academic spirit, you know. But first class today is criminal law. Tomorrow I have contract, which I did contract over the fall. It's a year-long semester, a year-long course instead of semester-long like the other classes. So I have contract, then property law. We're starting that this semester. Interested in finding what that's about. And then I have contracts, property, and constitutional law tomorrow. But today we just have cram, so let's just get today started. So before I actually get my morning started, I just wanted to come on here and reflect about my last semester and kind of some of what I'm hoping I could get done this new semester. So again, grades haven't come out. So they said the grades come out kind of like by next week, but one already came out today. I checked it and we're not gonna talk so much about that. But yeah, just like what I'm thinking I'm gonna change, what am I gonna keep on doing this new semester. So I felt like last semester I really like just focused on doing the best that I could. I said that so many times, which is doing like what felt healthy for me, what didn't feel like I was straining myself too much, but still putting in the amount of work that needed to be done. And I feel like that's always a good like base point to just get started from, especially since it's a new year. A lot of people are feeling very called to like start new routines, to start doing things differently. And I think more so towards me is just finding out what worked for me and just deciding, am I going to keep on doing the same things, or am I going to change those patterns or those habits that I started. So that is kind of what I'm feeling right now. I feel like the motto for this new semester is just do it afraid. I feel like there's a lot of times where you're considering doing something, but you're like, just the fear is just getting to you. And some people let themselves just get swallowed up by that fear, and they let the fear of like failure or just the fear that it's not gonna work out just stop them from trying initially. And I don't feel like that's gonna be me. Like, I feel like this new year, I'm focused on, even if I am afraid, I'm still gonna try it. I'm still gonna dip my foot in the water, especially because like it's a law school. Like, it's so easy to just get caught up in, you know, the competitiveness, the fact that your other classmates may be doing something different. But like, yeah, I just don't feel like that's necessary. So yes, as I was saying, just making sure that I'm checking myself, making sure that I'm able to be humble, Making sure that I am able to reach out of myself and reach out to other people, because there are so many communities here. There are so many people who are genuinely just like so focused on you, so focused on your success, because we are a community at Howard. So I just want to make sure that I am keeping that in mind as I'm going on into this new semester. And I forgot to introduce myself. Hi, if you're seeing me for the first time, my name is Raji and I am a 1L at Howard University School of Law. This is my first year at Howard, and today's the first day of a new semester. So I'm so excited. I don't feel nervous like I did my first semester. And I'm just like so glad I started documenting my law school experience, because just being able to watch those videos and just be reminded of the thought that I had in my head, what I was feeling, just top tier. Classroom right now. This is not my class, but I came in here so I can just get a little bit of work done before classes start. Just in this big classroom by myself, enjoying the vibes. Hi guys, so y'all have seen me in this classroom before during my finals vlog, but I'm just back here. I think I like this little vibe. Most people are not in here for the classes because like this is kind of not where the classes are. They use this for bar prep, so I'm just here chilling. Today is Wednesday, January 9th. And yeah, I'm just feeling good, you know, enjoying the vibes. I just got out of my first class, which is legal writing. I have criminal law later this afternoon, after lunch. So I'm just waiting on my friends while we go get lunch and I like catch up on readings. It's the third day, so I'm not like catching up on readings. It's just like we don't really have a lot of readings. And this week, this entire like period is kind of busy because like this is job application season, so most of the time I'm trying to apply to jobs but also like realizing that I need to read and do all that type of stuff. It's been kind of, I'm trying to get my schedule fixed or get my routine set, but I just like, you know, I'm still trying to figure it out. But yes, like I said, just been prioritizing like myself and doing things for myself. In class today, we did like an activity where we talked about what we did over the break. And over the break, I read this one book, 101 Essays That Would Change Your Life. And basically, the essay, like, hi.
Are you busy?
No.
Okay.
I'm just talking. I'll talk to you later. Hi y'all, today is Thursday, yes, so today is Thursday, January 11th. I just got out of my second class. The classes today are kind of crazy, they're like kind of back to back. So my first class contract is from 9:30 to 10:20, and then yes, to 10:20, and then I have property from 10:40 to 12:20, and then we have like a little 40 minute break or an hour long break, and then we have another class. But today the last class, constitutional law, is canceled in a way. It has us going to the courtroom to go like watch some lectures and watch like a MOOC. I don't think it's actually a MOOC thing. I think it's the South Africa, yes, it's the South Africa taking Israel to the United Nations because of the whole Israel Gaza thing that is going on. So we're going to see that. I'm actually excited to see that. But I just wanted to come in and say hi. Yesterday I was kind of interrupted. I was talking and then one of my friends just came in and we just started chopping it up. Excuse the noise, I don't know what's going on, but yeah, I'm just kind of enjoying the vibes today. I'm in this little class, y'all, you know the vibes right now. I'm just in this little classroom. I feel like this entire week, low-key, like since January started, I haven't been in the new year spirit. I feel like I'm still operating kind of like in 2023, so I just kind of want to be by myself. So because like I feel like I've just been spending a lot of time with other people, and I just want to be by myself so I can have that like mental clarity that comes with being alone. I just want to be in my own space too, so kind of doing that. So that's why I'm here, just like taking a little me time. But I missed y'all. I feel like I've not really spoken a lot just because like I've not really had the chance to. But yes, in this vlog, or in this new semester, let me tell you what I've been noticing. So I've noticed that now I feel kind of tired. When I came in first semester, I had this like newfound sense of rigor, you know, they tell you about law school is your first semester. But now I just feel burnt out. I feel like the break was not enough. I don't feel well rested. So this first week is still getting kind of slow. Like I'm still just trying to get back into the groove of things. But hopefully by like, you know, the coming weeks, I'm back in that law school mentality. Because it just, I was like, it feels weird. I feel like this is the kind of mental tiredness I had during finals period last semester. But it's the beginning of a new semester, so what's going on? But hopefully that is gonna get better as the year, as the time goes by this semester. But overall this semester, like I feel like a lot of people shared that same like feeling of tiredness, just because man, last semester really, it took a lot out of people. And I said, I came on and I was like, yes, like it wasn't so bad, but I guess that was me during the period, like going through it. But now that I'm on the other side, now that I can look back and be like, whoa, what a shit show that finals period was. It really was a shit show. Like I felt like I was in a sense of panic the entire time. I lost so much weight. Like, I went back home and my friends and my family were so confused. In my eyes, I didn't think anything happened. And I went back home and they were like, bro, is this from stress or like what's going on, babes? So I did think finals definitely affected my mental health, but at the time it wasn't something that I was really aware of until like after, when I took my break and I was just like, oh, it just feels so good to do nothing during the break. And yeah, during the break, like, I really don't think I did much. The last time I saw y'all, my friend came to DC to spend some time with me before I went back home for Christmas break. During the break, I was just mostly hanging out with friends, you know, doing those sort of things, just taking a break. Actually, I was doing job applications, so that's why I said the break didn't feel enough. I was doing job applications, I was working on my application documents. Even now, I'm here because I'm low-key trying to get some applications done. Like, it's a lot. Like, it really is a lot. Like, you're supposed to start applying to jobs, like, during the summer break. Most of the deadlines are kind of mid-January. So, like, during the Christmas break is when most people start applying. That's when most of the applications start opening. And then you can turn them in. But I'm not done. I've applied to, like, 10 places so far. And the goal is, like, 40 to 50. So, we're going to keep applying. Hopefully, by the end of this week, I want to be at, like, 25. So we'll see how that goes. But yeah, I just wanted to come in and say hi to y'all. I don't really have a lot going on right now. I just feel like classes are picking up, and at the beginning is when it's kind of easier to understand because it's like a fresh slate. But I feel like in most of my classes, I've been getting a lot of information that I feel like transfers. Like, I was in constitutional law and criminal law and property, actually, those three classes. I hear a lot of things I studied in undergrad regarding like criminal justice, especially with the criminal law class with criminal justice. I did an internship in undergrad where I basically was a student at a correctional facility. Like, it was an inside out college exchange program, so you go to the correctional facility. It's kind of like a seminar type class. Once a week we go there and you just talk to the inmates, and that was such an eye-opening experience for me. Like, that experience just totally just changed my mindset about the law and the way I perceived the criminal justice system. So kind of building on that knowledge that I had from those type of avenues that I kind of studied briefly in undergrad, building on that now in law school is kind of like, you know, it's kind of like a circle, what they call it, a full circle moment. There we go. Learning a lot about the things I learned in philosophy in my constitutional law class. So we were talking about the state of nature and basically like natural law, and Thomas Hobbes, John Locke, Rousseau, Nietzsche, their type of like ideas towards the social contract, towards the you know, just the idea of nature, basically just the idea of nature and what we consider to be natural and how that interprets in like the constitutional law realm. So anyways, all that to say is like the education has been kind of getting a full circle. Like, I went back yesterday because we were talking about that and I was like, Hobbes, that sounds real familiar. So I went back and I went to my Google Drive from undergrad and I was like reading some of the papers. Y'all, I was a smart little girl. Like, I'm 21 and I'm in law school, and when I was in undergrad, like 17, 18 years old, I was a smart little girl. Like, my words are kind of articulate. Like, I'm reading, I'm like, stop, she's so articulate. Like, her words are like butter. But yeah. I just got back from class. We just had like a seminar thing. I think I talked to y'all about that. Grades are out. That's what I came here. Grades are out. Well, the way Howard does it is like, I think they're putting down the grades like one by one. So last semester, fall semester, I had four classes. I had five actually. So I had contract, torts, legislation and regulation, civil procedure, and legal writing. Legal writing and contracts are year-long courses. Torts, LegReg, and CivPro are semester-long courses. So those three are the only ones that are going in our transcript for the fall. And then contracts and legal writing will be in the spring. So in the spring, we'll have like more classes. But I felt like, anyways, so my torts grades came out like on Monday, like literally first thing Monday morning. Someone just dropped on the Discord. First of all, like, why are y'all the bearers of bad news? But someone just dropped on the Discord that the CivPro grades are out. And I don't even know how to feel. I feel like when the torts grades came out, I was like, that was exactly my, because I was just like, I don't know what to feel. I don't know what to feel for CivPro too. I felt like towards, I really didn't have the chance to like view my, like, what's the core, like record my reaction, because I was just like, I saw it on the Discord and I was like, what the fuck? What's, I was like, is everything out? So I just like, y'all know how it be. But today I said, I'm gonna come out and show y'all what it feels like, just like reacting to what I got. Hopefully y'all just cross your fingers, but cross your fingers. Let's go check it out. So I got the same grade that I got in torts for CivPro, which was not a bad, y'all saw what I said my reaction was for torts, like it was not a bad grade, but what the fuck? Like, it's exactly the same thing, the same number of points. I don't know if it's like, but what? Okay, y'all wait. So I was low-key, like, when I saw my reaction, I was like, because the grades were exactly the same thing, so I was at least expecting to be higher. I mean, thank God it wasn't lower, but I was at least expecting to be higher. But at the same time, like, the grade was not a bad grade. Like, I talked to my mentor and she was like, congratulations, like, you, it was not a bad grade. But now I like went to go talk to my mentor and I was like, what would this mean with like summer job applications, because that's really what the grades are for. So I would disinterpret it like summer job applications, and she was like, if you get this type of grade that consistently and you have like good applications, you should get like a pretty solid summer job opportunity. And I was like, okay, that's what I wanted to hear, thank you. But yeah, what the fuck. Hi y'all, good morning. Today is Friday. It's Friday. So I feel like I need to be productive. I just kind of got ready. I'm just wearing this little hood. It's not too crazy. yeah, I feel like I need to like actually start getting stuff done, because I talked about it yesterday that I've just been feeling pretty like tired and mentally drained. So I'm just planning, today is just my day of like trying to get my stuff back in order. So I'm planning to leave, I have a class at 10:10. It's currently like 8:50 maybe. So I'm gonna go make breakfast right now and pack something for lunch and then go on campus. And my plan is just to stay on campus the entire like day ish and just like get some work done, because like I actually need to start buckling down for real. So not really readings, but like I want to start applying to a lot more summer opportunities. And I know I've been talking about like applying to jobs and stuff, and I've been wanting to also kind of show y'all what that looks like, but it's been kind of difficult because I'm just navigating it for the first time. And I'm not sure what type of information I can like put out. I mean, it's pretty basic, like, you know, most of the time when I'm applying to jobs, like, I'm just trying to get it on from wherever I am. So I don't really think about like filming it and stuff, but just turning in job applications. Right now I'm applying to a lot of firms because I do want to work in corporate, doing like transactional work and stuff. Right now the kind of like practice areas that I'm interested in is like corporate. I do want to do corporate. I don't want to do litigation. And if you're like, you don't really understand what that is. So basically, like, I would say the law is divided into two parts. That's what I heard. But it's like litigation and transaction. Litigation are those lawyers that y'all see on TV, you know, arguing in front of a judge. And that can be like civil cases, criminal cases, different practice areas, but within like litigation, like you're actually going to court, versus transactional work is like basically like working behind, I wouldn't say behind the scenes, but like mostly what transactional lawyers do is like corporate work, like working in firms or like working for the NBA in their legal department, just like dealing with like the transactional part. So like contracts, it can be like antitrust, intellectual property. So for like the practice area of intellectual property, for example, there can be intellectual property like litigation lawyers that are actually going to court to like defend the, like the patents and stuff. But they're also like could be like transactional lawyers that are, you know, drafting all the contract and, you know, talking to the client and drafting the contracts for the, what they call them? Child. But yeah, like, you know, just like kind of, and I feel like it's kind of hard for me to also talk about it because I feel like I don't know what I'm talking about because I'm just a first year. I haven't really had much experience, and I don't think they really do a good job of like trying to make sure we understand kind of what all the like job opportunities or experiences would look like. But also because I guess that's what your summer job opportunities are supposed to be for. But yeah, like I'm just like applying to more jobs, sending out more applications. That's kind of what I want the goal of today to be mainly. I want to get at least like 5 to 7 done today. Hi guys, so back here in the same room, yeah, I've seen me here. I just kind of wanted to come on and talk about grades. I know, like, I saw my second grade yesterday, and my reaction was kind of like, I was going back and I was watching the video, and my reaction was kind of like not really indicative of what the grade was. I was like, what? Like, I got the same grade in the other class, but it was like not a bad grade. And I said it here, oh, like, it's not a bad grade, but I still looked kind of sad. And I was on Reddit yesterday, and somebody was just talking on one of the forums that I was on, and they were like, yeah, law students, like, I feel like, I was saying yesterday that everyone just looks tired, and the person was basically saying that yes, like, because a lot of people this semester, they got their grades back, and some people, like, their grades is exactly what they expected. Some people, they thought they would do better, some people thought they would do worse, so they're kind of adjusting. But the person also said, like, for law students, like, they get an A minus and they're sad because they didn't get an A plus, or they get a B and they're sad because they didn't get an A or something like that, and they don't really like sit down and understand the accomplishment that it is to get the grade that they got. And that's kind of what I was kind of reflecting on yesterday, because I was like, I got a really, really good grade. Like, I know, like, I know I said I went to talk to my mentor and she said it was a really good grade. She got kind of similar grades her first year. But comparison really is the thief of joy, because like I was really kind of feeling sad about it, because I was like, oh yes, the grades are good, but like they're not what I expected. Like I expected way better, or I expected to be like the number one in the class or whatever, whatever. And it's like, I don't think those are my expectations. When I came on here, I kept saying it, my expectations was just to do the best I could, and I did the best that I could with what I had, and it gave me pretty good results. So I kind of just wanted to like just preface the video that I shot yesterday. I'm really, really, really happy with my grades. I am like truly like, especially since it was my first semester of law school, and I didn't do terrible. Like I didn't fail out of my school. I didn't fail. I did really good. So it's something that I should have been like celebrating over. I should have just not like dismissed it so casually and just like be sad that I didn't get better, because I know there are people who would be content or who would literally be praying for the type of grades that I got. So yeah, just wanted to put that out there. Yeah.
Hi guys. So I am here. Today is Sunday, January 14th. I'm here in my little like study room in my apartment, just like kind of chilling out. I am like applying to jobs right now. OCI, I look, just ignore that. But OCI season is basically upon us. OCI is on-campus interviews. So basically you just like bid. So you apply to a bunch of law firms, summer job applications, basically. And then they come on campus and do like interviews if they choose to like, you know, follow through with you. And then after the interviews, they can like send you an invitation, basically like you've been accepted type of stuff. So just part of like the job application process is OCI. So I'm just like, today's the deadline. I kind of procrastinate. It should not be surprising right now, but I kind of procrastinated on it, and now we're here. So what can we do? Yeah, I think it's kind of snowing outside today. It's like flurries right now, right? Y'all just heard it. She's like, oh, it's snowing. Yeah, but it's like little flurries right now. So it just kind of sucks that I'm just here. I had plans for today, but I'm not sure if I can go anymore because the weather is kind of like eh. But also I'm doing this, but hopefully like the faster I get done with this, the faster I'm able to go. So I'm not sure how much like I can show on here, but basically this is how it is. You just come, it's like your school organizes it. You go to OCI and it's a bunch of firms on there. You turn in like your resume and stuff. Yeah.
Guys, it's snowing. Oh my God. This is my first like actual, I mean like low-key it's snowing in Texas, but it's not snow. Will I ever get it right? Will I ever take it slow? I'm always waiting for the chorus line. I'm always singing to the words I know. Better than I take a risk. Better than the laugh me out. I like pretending that the moment waits for me instead of knowing that it never does. Thank you.
here.